I'd like to talk a little bit about the way in which plants uptake and use nitrogen. And that process starts in the soil, where nitrogen is found in a number of forms, including as organic nitrogen, which comes from living things, NH4+, ammonium, NO3- nitrate, and NO2- nitrite. So when things die and decompose, organic nitrogen is converted into ammonium by the process of mineralization, which is done by a number of bacteria and fungal organisms. And then ammonium is converted first to nitrite and then nitrate through the process of nitrification, which is done by bacteria. So we know that plants need nitrogen to make things like the chlorophyll molecule or DNA, but they also need it for amino acids. So I'd like to follow a nitrate molecule through the plant as it is converted into amino acid nitrogen. Plants take up nitrate and ammonium nitrogen through specialized membrane channels, and the process of the conversion of nitrate involves two intermediates, and both those intermediates are very reactive. So the conversion process goes very quickly, and the transcription of the DNA that codes for the enzymes that facilitate those reactions is a function of the concentration of nitrogen in plant cells to ensure that those reactions happen quickly. So in the first step, in which nitrate is converted to nitrite, occurs in the cytoplasm with reducing power from NADH or NADPH, and it is catalyzed by the enzyme nitrate reductase. The second step, because of the reactivity of the intermediates, occurs in the plastids, and that's where nitrite is converted to ammonium by the enzyme nitrite reductase. And this occurs with reducing power from ferredoxin or NADH, depending on the part of the plant in which it's occurring. So where in the plant do these things happen? It turns out it depends to some degree on the form of nitrogen the plant is using and also on the species of plant. So here we have the percentage of different forms of nitrogen found in the xylem, and you'll see that it varies quite a bit with plant species. Okay, so here's the final step where we go from ammonium to glutamine, and this can actually happen through a number of metabolic pathways. This is one called the GOGAT cycle, and you'll see that first we take our ammonium molecule and it joins with a glutamate molecule, and through catalysis with glutamine synthetase and energy from ATP, the nitrate molecule replaces this oxygen down here as an amino group. So it produces a glutamine molecule with two amino groups, just like that. So then we add a molecule of 2-oxoglutarate, which actually comes from the Krebs cycle of cellular respiration. And you'll notice that this molecule is different from glutamate because it has this carbonyl group up here instead of an amino group. So what this can do with catalysis from glutamate synthase and energy from NADH or ferredoxin is to replace that carbonyl group with one of the 2 amino groups from glutamine. So that produces 2 glutamate molecules. One of those glutamate molecules is the product of the reaction, and the other is used to combine with another molecule of ammonium to start the cycle all over again. So, I should also just mention the role of symbiotic nitrogen fixation. The atmosphere is over 70% N2, where nitrogen molecules are bound with a triple bond. So it takes significant energy to break those triple bonds and make that nitrogen available to the plant, 16 ATPs approximately. But this process can occur in anaerobic root nodules, which are formed through the symbiosis of plant roots with bacteria. The plants in the family Fabaceae do this with bacteria, a number of genera, including the genus Rhizobium, and the alder trees also do this. So another significant source of nitrogen for plants. All right, thanks for listening, and please let me know in the comments if you have any questions.